My dear children, how are you all? Welcome back to English class. Today we are going to read the poem Firework Night, written by Enid Blyton. Enid Mary Blyton was born on 11th August 1897 in East Dulwich, London, United Kingdom. Her parents were Thomas Carey Blyton and Theresa Mary Harrison Blyton. This poem, Firework Night, has been copied above as it is written in the book, The Enid Blyton Poetry Book, published in the year 1934. She was an English children's writer whose books have been among the world's bestsellers since the 1930s. She died on 28th November 1968. Her notable works are The Famous Five and The Secret Seven. Now, let us go to the warm-up session, children. Students, do you know God has created this beautiful earth, provided with pure water, air and land as a gift for humans. But we humans have mostly polluted everything. In addition, we have added noise pollution also. Let us see some of the most popular causes of noise pollution on humans and wildlife. They are industrialization, poor urban planning, social events, transportation, construction activities, household chores, noise from air traffic, catering and nightlife, animal sound, all these causes hearing problems, psychological issues, physical problems, sleeping disorders, cardiovascular issues, that is related to heart problems. Children, how does noise pollution affect people in old age home? Let us see now. The people will suffer from hearing impairment, sleep disturbances, cardiovascular disturbances, and disturbances in mental health and impaired task performance. These health problems can affect all age groups and especially children. Now let us see how does noise pollution affect the animals. Noise pollution affects animals by the way of a reduction in feeding patterns, hearing problems, the reproduction problems, reduction in production and behavior changes. Let us see how does noise pollution affect the birds. Health defects such as stunted growth, issues with their reproduction will be caused for birds. The ability to hear predators will be jeopardized. Let us go to the poem. Bang! What's that? Bang! Bang! Oh! Hark! The guns are shooting in the dark. This particular poem focuses on a dog being scared by the fireworks on bonfire night. A large, what is the meaning for bonfire? A large open air fire used for burning rubbish or as part of a celebration. A dog gets scared. The dog is afraid by the fireworks, the crackers on bonfire night. Bang! A sudden, loud, sharp noise. The meaning for hark is listen. The dog hears the sound of the guns shooting in the dark. He listens to the bang bang sound and asks, what's that? Friends and big ones too. Bang bang bang. What shall I do? The dog asks out of fear, what shall I do? I hear the little guns and big guns being shot everywhere. Bang bang bang. What shall I do? Mistress, master, hear me ill. I am out of doors. I want your help. Let me in. Oh, let me in. before those fireworks begin. The meaning for ill is a short, sharp cry, especially of pain or alarm. The dog asks his master and his mistress to hear his painful cry. He requests him to allow him into the house before those fireworks begin again. To shoot again, I can't bear that. My tail is down, my ears are flat. I am trembling here outside the door. Oh, don't you love me anymore? The meaning for trembling is to shake slightly or short movements as from fear. The dog says that the fireworks will begin to shoot again. He can't bear that and his tail is down and his ears are flat out of fear. His body is shaking slightly from fear outside the door. The dog asks his mistress and master whether they love him anymore. I think I will die with fright unless you let me in tonight. The meaning for fright is a sudden intense feeling of fear. The dog says that he thinks he will die with a sudden intense feeling of fear unless the master lets him into the house that night. Shall we let him, children? Oh, now the door is opened wide. I am rushing through. I am safe inside. The lights are on. It's warm and grand. The meaning for rushing is moving with urgent haste or fast. Grand, splendid. That mistress, the lady asks permission from her children. And after getting permission, she opens the door. The dog rushes through and feels that now he is safe inside. The lights are on. It's warm and grand inside the house. Let me lick your hand before I sleep behind the couch. The meaning for couch is a type of high bed or sofa. Slip, glide. Do you know, children, usually dogs lick our hands to show their gratitude. Here also the dog feels grateful to the mistress as she opened the door and let the dog in, who was scared of fireworks. He wants to lick her hand to show his gratitude before he slips behind the couch. There, I will hide myself and crouch in safety till the banks are done. Meaning for crouch is adopt a position where the knees are bent and upper body is brought forward and down. Done meaning is over. The dog says he will hide in safely behind the sofa till the bang sounds are over. Then to my kennel I will run and guard you safely all the night because you understood my fright. Kennel meaning is a small shelter for a dog. Fright, a sudden intense feeling of fear. After the crackers sounds are over, the dog says he will run to his kennel and guard the people in the house safely all throughout the night. Because the mistress understood his fear and allowed him into the house. Friends, do you have pet animals at home? Please remember to keep your pets inside your house and make them feel safe and secure during fireworks on bonfire nights, that is during Diwali. Because animals are scared on hearing crackers sound. Okay, now let us go to the rhyming words, rhyme scheme and personification. Let us see what are rhyming words. Rhyming words are two or more words which have the same sound. Words rhyme if they have similar sounds when said aloud. Rhyming words usually occur at the end of the lines in a poem. Rhyming words make poems or songs fun to sing. For example, out came the bright sunshine, down crept its light. Into the sea too bright. The above lines, the rhyming words are light and bright. What is a rhyme scheme? A rhyme scheme is a specific pattern used in a poem which determines which lines rhyme in the poem. Poets write poems with a rhyme scheme or a pattern. It is the arrangement of rhymes in a poem or a stanza. For example, see this poem. Upon a nice mid-spring day, let's take a look at nature's way. Breathe the scent of nice fresh air. Feel the breeze within your hair. The grass will poke between your toes. Smell the flowers with your nose. Clouds form shapes within the skies, and light will glisten from your eyes. The rhyme scheme of this poem can be determined by the end word in each line. The first line ends with the word day, and the second line ends with way. As both words rhyme with other, they are given the letter A. The third line ends with the word yeah, and the fourth line ends with have. These two words do not rhyme with the ending words of the first two lines. So they are given the letter B. We get a rhyme scheme AA, BB, CC, DD for this poem. Personification, it is a figure of speech in which a thing, an idea or an animal is given a human attribute. Human qualities are given to non-human things or ideas for a better understanding the writer's message. The use of personification also helps to show a character's attitude towards inanimate objects. This adds interest and fun to poems and stories. The literal meaning of the word should not be taken into consideration. For example, the sun smiled down upon them. Justice is blind. The wind howled in the night. The moon played hide and seek with the clouds. The city never sleeps at night. The boat danced in the puddle. The flowers nodded their heads. The thunder grumbled. The lightning danced all over the sky. The iron hands of death. The popcorn left out of the bowl. A dog's whistle. Do you know? A dog's whistle, also known as silent whistle or Galton's whistle, is a type of whistle that emits sound in the ultrasonic range, which people cannot hear, but some other animals can, including dogs and domestic cats, and is used in their training. It was invented in 1876 by Francis Ketton and is mentioned in his book Enquiries into Human Faculty and Its Development, in which he describes experiments to test the range of frequencies that could be heard by various animals such as a house cat. Children, we have come to the end of this poem. I hope you might have understood well. I will meet you in the next class. Till then, obey your parents. Take care. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.